It's, you know, about 8 o'clock, 7 degrees last night, which is about 40. I'm gonna try to fish these little pencil weeds in areas close to deep water first thing in the morning, thinking the fish might be wandering around looking for bluegills, perch, whatever they're eating, I don't care. But I'm gonna use the structure bug, rage tail. I'll go a little later on in the shallower water when it heats up a little bit. We're supposed to have a big range from 40 degrees to about 70 something between 9 or about 10 o'clock to about 2 o'clock. So I think that's gonna be my window of opportunity for big fish. But for now, I'm gonna throw to everything I think potentially a fish might be sitting near or on those big fall hogs. I keep my eyes peeled for anything, you know? Little holes in the arrowhead. Also, you look down, you see a log or something, a hole. And you can use that for future reference for summertime fishing. In the fall, you can see, who else is out here? There's nobody here. You got almost the whole lake to yourself. Public lakes, public ramp. That's the beauty of fishing in fall. The fish are big, they're biting, and sometimes you got the lakes all to yourself. What else could you ask for? When I'm out in the fall for bass, there's three choices of those perfect plastics made by Strike King. I call them perfect because they catch fish. They're nice and coffee scented. Fish hold them and eat them, but they provoke strikes with that little rage tail. And my top three choices, rage menace, y'all know, the rodent, and last but not least, the new DB structure bug. Something about these three baits, they provoke strikes, the fish hold them, they give you that extra edge. You know, just a couple seconds to just feel it, let them hold it, he ain't gonna spit it out, and then set. But these three choices, rage menace, rodent, and structure bug, you gotta get some. Where are you? There we go. There's a start to my fall largemouth. The one I just missed back there was double the size of you, but you know what? You found the little structure bug. Nom, nom, nom. Look how nice and clean those fish are. Cold. Wow. Here, I'll put them back. We're after a lot bigger ones than that. Ready? Go on. You know, there's a transition when everything all of a sudden goes back to shallow. And you say to yourself, well, it's cold. You know, fish get affected. Uh-uh. Food's there. They get that trigger effect. Winter's coming. Just like us, just like bears. And it's a phenomenon, but happens every year, everywhere, especially here in Ontario. So I'm going to fish shallow, like I said. Get in there. Almost go to the same spots I go to when the season first opens. Shallow water. Fish on the feed bag. Hopefully catch them with the DB structure bug. Let's keep going. Okay, well, the structure bugs, there's something you got to do when you open them up in the package. They're all separated very nice like that. Is they got the appendages, right? You just got to pull it apart like that. Each side, turn upside down, the bottom, and then those little antennas at the bottom like that, just pull them apart. That's all you want to do. So it just sits perfect like that. And those little wings, little tail, again, it's got that little rage tail, little curvature at the bottom. That design is created to make fish bite. Honestly, you just gotta throw it in. It's got that real nice little vibration, subtle. Fish see it, fish eat it. But just remember, break off the little arms, break off the little tail, so that bait falls free. Those little tentacles and stuff and little wings fall and entice bites. Oh, took some coaxing, hey. Took some coaxing, didn't I? Look where he got it too. Right through the nose, man. Like, you know, that fish was never gonna come off like that. Look at it. Whoa, got me with those fins there. Just another decent fish. Not the kind of fish I'm looking for in the fall like this, but you know what? He's still a cookie cutter. You know, nice and thick back. Look how healthy. Just a beautiful looking largemouth bass sitting in this stuff. Water's higher, feels comfortable. We're gonna put him back. He can go back. Hey, ready? Look at him go back. They say fall is a time of plenty. Well, sometimes it's plenty of time between catching fish, but still, I'm out fishing. It's a beautiful day. The atmosphere, the trees, everything is just perfect. All we need is those fish to be a little bit bigger. You know what I mean? Like their mouths a little farther from their tail. And I'm pretty sure I persevere, keep doing it, hat down in those hot spots, circle around, let the sun get up, warm them spots, we're gonna get them. Let's keep going. These little structure bugs, I got it on a 4-odd extra wide gap. I want a lot of bite there, so when a fish actually grabs, I got lots of room to get those hook sets, okay? And, you know, I'm fishing anywhere between 2 feet to about 6-7 has been the key today. And I got a little bobber stop, because I want it to go exactly in those little grass patches and pads and stuff. I don't want to drag it. And I got 3/16 little tungsten worm weight there, and the green pumpkin, because the water here, it's got some clarity to it, but it's just a little bit of contrast. It's a natural tone with the black flake in there. You know, I've got some other ones that have some blues, some red flake and that kind of stuff. I want it to be as subtle as possible. So they go in, just looks like something that they've been eating. Bluegills, perch, sunfish, everything has that green. So the green pumpkin, you can't go wrong. And I've been throwing it on the Legend Extreme 7-4 heavy action, 20 pound gamma fluorocarbon, you can't miss. The only thing you gotta do is once in a while, check your line after you catch a good fish, because they rub against stuff. You want any abrasions and nothing that potentially on a hook set from a big fish can break you off and break your heart. Man, oh man, when I'm working through these pencil weeds like this, my focus is just like a hound dog, I tell you. I'm looking to the left, center, right. But what I'm looking for is any clumps that are a little bit thicker than the rest. It's all about the same depth, about 4 feet of water. But I'm looking for those little clumps that potentially maybe have a little bit more weed, grass or something that makes that fish comfortable to go into. And if he's there, I make that right pitch, it's over. That's what I mean right there. Where are you, huh? Where are you? Come in the plate. Whoa, there we go. That's what I'm talking about right there. That's a nice fish right there. Ooh. Just taking it time, man. Look where he's got it too. Hey, those bugs bug bass, boy. But that's a good bass no matter where you fish, from Alabama, Tennessee, Florida to Ontario. It's fall and everybody's eating big. Me, him, and you. I'm gonna put them in a box, take some pictures, and I'll let you go after, okay? Okay, let's put them in a box. That's how I like how they fight, man. When you throw it in like that and all of a sudden you feel, boom, he's there. You know, I made a pitch earlier to that same little patch of stuff with nothing. I put it about 2 feet more past it, lift it up, there was weight. You don't hesitate. You feel weight, give it to him. That's how you get him. Regroup, let's get back out and catch another fish. When I'm in the shallow stuff like this, I got logs, I got pads, grass, except eelgrass. But the stuff right in front of me there, that's the stuff that I like right there. It's lay down stuff. It creates like a canopy as well, but I like to stay back. So what I'll do is power poles down. And I know I'm not moving anywhere. So I can just dissect it, make my pitches right inside. The highest potential spot is right inside. It's dark. It's about 3 feet deep. Again, like I said, the water's high here now because all the rain. These fish can be almost anywhere, but they'll still go to that high potential stuff. Something with overhanging cover. And this way I can just sit, stay back. There's no way they know I'm even here. And just pick apart that little grass patch, putting it in, let it fall, lift up and shake. You know if a fish is there. If it's weeds, you lift up a little bit and you feel a little stuff. Fish, it's just that, I don't know, I would call it that spongy sensation. It's a gut feeling. You just know it's a fish. Hit them and bring them in the boat. But the power poles, it ain't just bling. Take your time, dissect the spot, and all you gotta worry about is getting bit. Come here. Oh, he wants to say hello to the camera, huh? Oh, he did, didn't he? Oh, he's all mean, he's bad. Oh, he's a bad one. Whoa, under the flooded tree, huh? Look how beautiful. Solid, thick fish. I love you. And look what he ate again, folks. You know what that is? The rage tail DB structure bug. And look at that. When it goes in, you give those fish an extra second, they will not spit these baits. There you go. But that's what I'm talking about right there. Just a solid, nothing to brag about. We got some braggers, but a solid, thick fish with potential to be real big one day, hiding on a flooded tree. We're gonna let him go. I'm gonna put him over here, so maybe he swims that way and away from the tree. But you ready? Oh yeah. Oh, he's going back to the tree anyway. It doesn't matter. I'm gonna go back around that tree. He gave you a nice show. He jumped right up top of your TV screens, splashed you all up. But working this stuff with baits like this, seriously, it's very important to buy enough of these baits that you don't run out when you're on the water. And you buy baits that you have potential to catch good fish with. Because you know what? Your time, my time is very valuable out in the water. So I want to use baits I'm going to catch fish with. You learn about techniques, GPS, and all that other kind of stuff. Good rods and reels, etc. But it comes down to good baits. Soft, smelly, with just a nice subtle action that makes bass bite and hold on. Patches of arrowheads, pads, and right in front of me here, again, a little patch of pads. Bass don't need much. Something they can hold to, relate to. A stem, a stick, one weed. A little patch like that, sheesh. You find it and the right fish is there, boy. You'll have a good time. That's why I love fall, man. Those big fish are on the feed, and when they want to eat, they eat. I'm here, you. I'm here, you. You were way back there, huh? Just another fat fish, boy. I'm almost done my day, but look at that. Just another, but look where he is again, eh? How many times? You know that's a good bite. Right through the schnoz, boy. He ain't going anywhere, but in the boat, on TV, and then back in the water, right? Back in the water. Chunky little largemouth. There he goes. You think to yourself, boy, all summer I've got him deeper and edges and weed lines and crankbait and everything else. But this time of year, I'm back in stuff like that. Heavy pencil weeds, pads, grass, you name it. The stuff that you think, man, really? Are they in there? Fall? It's a time of plenty, boy. Big fish. Go back in the shallow water to feed. And you got to follow them. Pick your times when you're fishing it. First in the morning, it wouldn't go too shallow. I'd fish maybe 5-6 feet of water. As the sun gets up and gets warmer, get tighter, go closer, skinnier water. Those fish move. They know where they want to be. You know, you get a real cold night and the water, the shallow water, you know, it does get real cold. And sometimes it'll push them out a little bit, but not far, you know. But as soon as it warms up, that peak time, like I said, from about 10, 11 to about 3, 4 o'clock, the sun's high, those fish, you can catch them all day. But the afternoons are peak. Here we go. Look where he got it again, folks. Right up through there, huh? Look at that. Right up, way at the back, because the water is higher. Why is that? Because it's been raining a lot. And look at that. On Extreme Angler, boys and girls, the fall bite. Is it big? Is it fun? You see him jump out of the water? He thinks he's a smallmouth bass. You're gonna join your buddy? And we're having a fun day, man. I'm telling you, boy, when it comes together sometimes, you know, the water is so high because a lot of rain. This particular lake's got a lot of creeks and stuff. So it brings in, a couple things happen. Water rises, the temperatures go down, but it doesn't matter. You know what, we're in a fall bite. Those fish may be offshore, all that kind of stuff like that. They're now tight again, they want to eat. That fish was so far back that as soon as I hit him, when he turned and stuff, I thought, what is this, a whale? But he's a good one. this shallow stuff is wicked, because when the fish are there, if they're big, your heart feels like it's coming out of his chest when you hit them. They turn sideways, they bang, knock against stuff. They are the alpha male. Sometimes the big females too. Oh, oh, and it's a bronze back. Look at him go, I think it is, yeah. Yeah, it's a bronze one. Just knew right away when he starts to jump, flip flop and fly. He don't know when to die. Fishing in the fall is one of the best times of year to catch smallmouth in Ontario and largemouth. You know why? Because you have virtually all the spots to yourself. You heard me say it before, but I mean, those docks that are just in the middle of nowhere, where you know guys usually run to them and all that kind of stuff. Most guys know where the good stuff is. But in the fall, September, October, early November, you got it to yourself. And don't kid yourself and think, again, oh, maybe it's too shallow that time of year. You know, the water gets cold. Yeah, it gets cold overnight. And early in the mornings, that wouldn't be my first choice. But come around 11 o'clock to about 3 or 4 o'clock, that's my choice. You know why? Because they go in to feed. The bluegills are there. The perch are there. All the food's there. And then they're there. So in the fall, don't be scared to go shallow in the afternoons, because that's where they are. That's where you should be. Yep. Nothing wrong with fish like that, huh? Look at him. Ready? He's coming in the boat, folks. Here he comes. That's what I like. When a plan comes together, boys. When a plan comes together, right there. Mr. Largemouth Bass. On the very last little dock. You think to yourself, oh, you know, I fished them all. I fished all the good stuff. And look what's there. Another chunky fat bass. I'm going to put them in there, take a couple pictures, let them go. But we're having a fantastic day. And you know what? It's over. I've caught enough fish. I've had a good time. It's about 3 in the afternoon. And we caught them like this. Let me put them inside there real quick. So next time you go out, late September, early October, and you know, you want to catch largemouth bass, get shallow, get big,